Să încercăm să punem și microfoanele care sunt pe jos acum, să le punem pe masă, dacă acolo este locul lor. Și vă propun să începem această conferință de presă, organizată la sfârșitul vizitei în România prin vicepreședintelui Comisiei Europene, domnul Frans Timmermans. Îi voi da cuvântul pentru a face o declarație de deschidere a acestei conferințe de presă, după care timpul rămas este la dispoziția dumneavoastră pentru întrebări. Mr. Timmermans, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon. I'm sorry, I don't speak Romanian, so I'll speak English. We had a fascinating citizens' dialogue on the border between Bulgaria and Romania last night in Ruse. I think more than 800 people attended, and it was really fascinating to be confronted with so many questions, and there was so much interest by the public. Much of the questions were related to issues of the rule of law, and both in Bulgaria and Romania, public is very interested in where we're heading with these subjects, and I confirmed that for the European Commission it is important to work with both Bulgaria and Romania to strengthen the rule of law, to make a success of the CVM, Cooperation and Verification Mechanism, and to continue improving the situation in both countries. Last night we had a joint meeting with the President of Bulgaria and the Prime Minister of Romania. I met the Prime Minister, I met the Justice Minister last night and today. I had talks in Parliament with the Presidents of both Houses and then with the committees as well. I had a meeting with the President of Romania, and went on a visit of a prison to get an impression of the issue of overcrowding in prisons and that there is a need for a solution. I want to state very clearly I'm looking forward to your questions, but the reason of my visit is the continuing cooperation between the European Commission and Romania. I am very strongly committed to this issue. In a previous capacity, I strongly favored Romanian accession to the European Union. I campaigned for this in my own country. And since accession, I've also been a strong supporter of the CVM process because I believe it is to the benefit of the citizens of Romania that the rule of law be structurally reinforced, that corruption be tackled, and that every single citizen of Romania would feel the protection of the law when needed. And the Commission will continue to work on that. Remarkable progress has been made in the last couple of years by Romania. We want this to continue, and we will do everything we can to make sure we create a success for this. Thank you very much, and I'm very much looking forward to your questions.
May I like to take the influence?
Oh, yes.
Da, vă rog. Cu rugămintea de a vă prezenta.
Claudius Ampir, Parliamentar Row. Please, as you know, our Prime Minister, Mr. Victor Ponta, is under investigation by the prosecutors. How would you assess this situation? Because the President asked for his resignation, he announced that he refuses. What do you think the Prime Minister should do in this situation? Thank you.
I'm not in a position to comment on internal political discussions in Romania, and the Commission is never makes any comments on specific cases that are before justice in any member state, including Romania. I'm here to try and improve the implementation of what we agreed in the CVM process. So I have no comments to make about what is happening in internal politics in Romania. This is something for Romanian politicians to decide.
Okay, but generally speaking, how do you assess such a situation when a prime minister of a member state is under investigation and he was asked for his resignation, but he refuses, and what is his legitimacy in his function?
You say generally speaking, and then you go immediately to the case at point. Generally speaking, we're not speaking generally, sir. We're speaking about a very, very specific case, and as you know very well, if you would get me to make general comments, you would stick those comments directly to the specific case, and I think there is no reason whatsoever why the European Commission would be making comments on a specific case in a member state. This is a case that is in the hands of the judicial authorities in Romania. The political side of things is in the hands of the President of the Republic and is in the hands of the Prime Minister and is in the hands of the Parliament. This has nothing to do with the European Commission, and I certainly will not make any comments on that.
Strongly related to the cooperation and verification mechanism and the activity of the justice system is the issue of removing the political immunity. The members of the National Parliament have blocked for several times the removal of the immunity for some politicians when the justice required their investigation. More than this, the voting is secret. The question is, do you have any recommendations for the Romanian authorities regarding any change in the procedure of removing the immunity or the secret voting? It happened and maybe it will happen again. What is the practice in other member states?
I spoke to both presidents of the Houses of Parliament about this morning. I reiterated our position that, in general, immunity of lawmakers is linked to their activity as lawmakers. And immunity does not cover any potential penal prosecution. And the presidents of both houses agreed with me on this point. And that's the general point we made. That's the general point I repeated. And I think this is the position the Commission will continue to present to the authorities of any member state, including Romania.
Can you say that again? Because
you didn't get it? Or? Well, immunity of lawmakers in general terms. In why do lawmakers have immunity? It's because in their activity as lawmakers, when voting or when presenting a position in Parliament, they should not be open to prosecution. That is why you have immunity of lawmakers. And that is why they have immunity, not to be prevented from being prosecuted in a penal case. That is a different matter. And this general principle is a principle both presidents of the houses agreed with me on this morning when we had a discussion.
End up so high in the chain of power in Romania? And the second, what did you discuss with Mr. Ponta in your meeting yesterday?
First of all, I think the report we've written that was published in January clearly states the progress made by Romania in all fields, tackling corruption at all levels. I think this is something that is to be underscored, that Romania made great progress in doing this, and I have nothing to add to that. I think, again, Romania has made great progress tackling corruption at all levels. The discussion I had with Prime Minister Ponta last night concentrated very much on elements of developments in the region, because we had also the President of Bulgaria at the table. We talked about the situation with Ukraine, with Russia, the developments surrounding Greece. We had a discussion about the situation in the former Yugoslav Republic of Macedonia. Those are sort of things we discussed last night at the table. Well, if you, it's, I mean, this is too complicated to say in a few words, generally speaking, the last couple of years, Romania has continuously made progress, significant progress, whereas in Bulgaria, for a time, there was no progress. It sort of stalled the process. Now you see that in Bulgaria, politically, it's quickly gearing up. The government, the prime minister are very much working strongly on this, the justice minister, interior minister, so you see things are really moving now, but they have a lot of catching up to do, as I said. Romania is in a different phase, has gone further in this. But in both countries, there's still a lot to do, and that's why the Commission will remain involved in this discussion. I think, the comparison I made yesterday is with an orchid. It takes a terrible long time before you get an orchid to bloom, to blossom, but then you also need to maintain it to make sure it doesn't die off. And this is something every single member state needs to do, not just Romania and Bulgaria, but the CVM is an extra instrument to help both countries to catch up. And once again, Romania has made remarkable progress, but we're not there yet. There are still recommendations made by the Commission. There are still steps that need to be taken. And I understand that a large majority of the Romanian population see merit in the CVM process, see merit in the Commission assisting and supporting Romania in making this progress, and we will certainly continue doing this. What I see is that in a member state, the different branches of government take their responsibility as they see fit. I have no comment to make on this specific case. The Commission will certainly not intervene in any way in a specific case. We've never done that. We will not start doing that now. And we will see how this pans out. For us, the important thing is that we support Romania in making structural reforms and making structural improvements in the workings of the rule of law institutes in this country. And we will continue to do that regardless of what happens in specific cases.
But do you think the Prime Minister should quit?
I once again want to repeat, and you can ask the question 20 times, you'll get 20 times the same answer. The European Commission has no comments to make on a specific situation in a specific member state. And this is something for the Romanian authorities to deal with themselves.
Mulțumesc. Dacă mai sunt întrebări, o revenire la Ioana.
Romania assumed within the cooperation and verification mechanism to ensure the stability of the anti-corruption legislation. It happens, a coincidence, that right now, during your visit in Romania, the National Parliament published no less than 20 legislative projects to modify the penal code and the penal procedure code, which will be discussed and possibly adopted the next week. Only four of them include some technical adjustments. The rest of them are controversial, being favorable for the persons investigated. Will the Commission take a position on this subject regarding the stability of the legislation? It's of high importance because if they get to come into force and we bring some changes, that will be extremely hard, if not impossible, to change back.
Well, now we're talking about legislation. We're not talking about a specific case, but about legislation. And the Commission will indeed carefully analyze amendments to the legislation, and we will certainly comment on that if we believe this is not an improvement of the situation. So there, this is our role, not going into specific cases, but in general terms, if the legislation has consequences for the rule of law and for the fight against corruption, we will certainly not keep silent, and we will take a position on that. But I haven't had the opportunity to look at the amendments, because I think they were just published a couple of hours ago, and they will be put up for a vote next week, I believe.
Dacă mai sunt întrebări, Nu mai văd nicio mână, așa că vă mulțumesc pentru participare și vă doresc o zi bună în continuare. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.